Hi, my name is Jared Rovny. I'll be your guide through physics, sometimes perceived as one of the more challenging of the hard sciences. And so for that reason, many students, especially students in the medical field, ask me, why do I need this? Why do I need to be studying physics if I'm going into medicine? And so briefly, I'm going to cover some important reasons. I think that this will be a useful thing for you, something that you can take with you in the future. And then what we're going to do for the rest of this introduction is first give a quick overview of the entire course, the topics we're going to be looking at and why we'll be looking at them. And then at the end of this introduction, before we get into the actual physical content, we're going to go over some key skills that will be very useful to you as you work in any of these problems that we're going to cover, or as you go to an exam setting or something for the future. But first, why are we studying physics? Why does somebody who's going to go into medicine need to know physics? I'm going to briefly cover three reasons that I think are really good reasons that you should be paying close attention in your physics course. First, for historical reasons, you should understand that physics has played a huge role in the medical sciences and the kinds of technology people have been able to come up with and understand using rigorous physical methods and quantitative methods to come up with all sorts of technology from MRI to PET scans to X-rays and many things that you'll be seeing and using. And for that reason, it's very important to be able to understand what these instruments are telling you and how to interpret the physics behind what you're seeing so that you can actually give a proper interpretation to the results. And that brings me to the second point, which is that physics is actually practical in the actual medical room. When you're looking at a patient who has any number of issues, everything about that patient is a physical system. The blood flowing through their veins is going to follow the fluid laws we discuss, as will the air going in and out of their lungs. Even the mechanical structure of their bones and the kinds of stresses that they feel from this or that thing or this or that reason or injuries all follow physical laws. And for that reason, even right in front of your patient, it's important to know some of the basic mechanics and the basic laws of physics that person's body and yours and mine and everybody's is always following. And finally, and one of the most important reasons to really work hard at physics and to understand what we're going to discuss is that the logical structure that we're going to approach physics with will be very, very useful in many other fields. Physics is important in a particular way, in a peculiar way, different from many other academic subjects in which you're given a lot of information and then you just have to reiterate that information in maybe an exam or something. In physics, it's different. We're not going to do that. We will give you a lot of information, but the idea will be you will be asked questions to which you do not know the answer. And this is very jarring for students sometimes initially, so it's good to know and to expect that this will be the case, that we're asked questions and we don't know the answer to those questions. And even I, when I'm going over problems with students or with colleagues, I never know the answer to the questions beforehand. That's not how we solve them. We solve them because what we've done in physics is to build a logical structure, a way to proceed when you're met with something intimidating and frightening even, that your first reaction and the first rule for any physics problem is to not panic. And so that will be our guiding principle, is that we will meet some things that might look intimidating, but we'll start at the beginning, proceed logically, not panic, and then solve the problems. And that mindset will be very useful to you, I hope, as you go into further disciplines. So with that, let's get started. We're going to first, as I said, do an overview. But it will be important as we go that you're able to know that what we might have at the top right are some labels, some important labels for you that you'll be able to help bookmark your studies with as we go. So you can see we'll highlight things that are important during exams. We'll highlight important definitions that you might want to write down or look over and refer to in the future. We'll be working through a lot of examples, and so I always encourage you to try to work these examples yourself first and pause if you need to and give them a shot, because even if you give it a quick try, you'll learn far, far more from when I do it if you try to tackle it first yourself. And then finally, we will be covering a number of equations, which is not something you want to memorize all the time, but you will certainly want to understand how to interpret these equations. And so if you see an equation in the letters, you don't always understand each letter, take the time to really understand what the letters mean, because then you may not have the equation in your head all the time, but the principle behind that equation will always be with you, and you'll be able to recall that in the future with far more ease than if you remember the equation by its letters.